On today's episode, we're going to take another look at the Ender 3 clone, the Geeetech A10, but it's evolved. I'll explain it all on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. Now, these may look similar, but they're actually three generations of the Geeetech A10. The first generation I did a review of back in October 2018. I'll put a link to that video up here and also in the description below. This is the next generation of this machine, and then this is the latest generation with some other upgrades that just came out within the last 2 or 3 months. Back when I did my review of this machine and compared it to Ender 3, there were some features I really liked. It's got a filament runout sensor. It's very easy to add auto level to this. You got the bracket and most of the wiring. You just have to add the sensor and then the firmware. And they also have 256K memory on their board, so there's plenty of room for the full Marlin. Now, a few of the things I didn't like is the cable they use between the LCD and the control board is an edge connector, and it's very weak. I actually broke one on a different Geeetech machine. All you have to do is set this down on something that stretches the cable, and it broke. So I recommended that they improve that. They also put single bearings on all the wheels instead of a double bearing. A lot of people complained about that because it can collect dirt and everything else in there. So that, it wasn't a problem for me, but that's something that a lot of people wanted them to fix. Now, I also had some reliability issues with this. I had a driver burnout because the current was sent too high and the motor was really getting hot. But they're socketed, so I could easily change that driver. So that's a nice feature. But overall, just the general quality of the Geeetech machines just don't seem as good after talking to a lot of people who've had a lot of different problems. But they seem to be trying to improve that. Their machines seem to be getting better, and I witness it in this guy right here. This is the next generation, and basically they just made improvements on what they heard from the community. First off, they improved that cable. It's now a pure ribbon cable, a real good, flexible, strong ribbon cable with IDC connectors that lock down, so it's much, much stronger. They went to two bearings on the wheels. Good move. And they also changed from a glass bed that was stuck to the aluminum to a build tack type material. It's easy to peel off. It's like a post-it note. You can pull it off, but it stays in place while you print. And the top surface loves PLA. PLA sticks to it. It's amazing how well it sticks to it. In fact, even if your nozzle isn't perfectly level, the PLA seems to still stick to it. I set it up and I couldn't get my prints off. It was sticking so well. So I lowered the bed a little bit lower than the nozzle than I normally would. It's working beautifully. So I'm trying to get more of these sheets for my Ender 3. Other than that, it's been pretty solid. The motors aren't getting too hot. The drivers, it's still 256 memory and still socketed drivers. So I think they've listened to community, improved this machine. I really, really like it. They have this machine on the Geeetech website for $179. So it competes well with the Ender 3 with some nice added features. So it's definitely something to consider. As long as they can keep the quality up, I think they're going to give Creality a run for the money with this. But then they went a step further. From this guy, we go to this guy. And this has only been out, I think, for a couple months. I noticed it because it's got a case right here where there's an open slot on these two guys. So I wondered what was different. I got a hold of it, tore it apart, and saw that there's a bigger motherboard in this thing. And that's what they advertise, a new motherboard. But it's also got an external FET for driving the heated bed. The heated bed on both these and even the Ender 3 is driven from the FET on the motherboard. This has an external FET so that it can handle more power or more current. So it's more reliable. This is the setup you would see on a bigger like CR10. So this is a much more reliable electronic setup and also a bigger fan to cool everything. This machine also has a micro SD card with the new motherboard. It now has a micro SD card right here in the front. But it still has the larger SD card behind the LCD like these two have. So if you want a micro SD, you have a slot for it. If you like the larger SD card, you have a slot for it. But you have to pick one or the other, because I notice if I try to plug them both in, it's going to read the larger one first, it appears. But whichever one you have in first, that's the one it's going to continue to read until you shut the machine off and turn it back on. And then it's going to read the first one, but it seems to default to the larger SD card first and then the micro SD card. So I've been printing from the micro SD card on this guy and it's been working really well. But it does cost more. They're charging $30 more for this over this guy. So is it worth the extra $30? It's more reliable in the long run, but I'm not sure you're really getting any more as far as a 3D printer. Now, this is an early unit, and I did find one issue, and it relates to the firmware. They're using the same Marlin 1.1.8 firmware on this that they use on here, which is fine. But when this one homes, the nozzle is actually off the bed, and the XY coordinates are -15x, -8y. But once it starts printing, it comes to 0, 0, which is right at the corner of the bed and prints fine. Well, this one, they added a little knob here to the bracket so it hits the stop switch sooner. So the nozzle ends up right at the corner, but it still says -15, -8. So when it starts printing, it shifts over that 15 millimeters. So every print on this machine is shifted over, nothing is centered. I tried different G-code to kind of offset it, but nothing really worked. So it's something in the firmware. I'm told there's a firmware update for this. I just haven't installed it, but that's the problem with getting one of these newer machines. That's the only real issue I have with this. Other than that, both these machines have been printing a lot of small prints, big prints, and printing them really well. So the quality I'm getting is fantastic. Not as good as my Ender 3, but close, because I'm using my Cura 4.4 profile that I tuned to the Ender 3. The hot ends on these guys are very similar. PTFE tube goes all the way down to the nozzle. And it's very similar, but a little bit different cooling because the cooling fan is on the side and the fins are a little bit different design. So I'm getting a little bit different flow. I'm going to have to tweak the settings a little bit for the A10s. But I'm probably getting about 90 to 95% the quality I'm getting on my Ender 3. So pretty good. What I like most about this, and this is not go buy this and instead of an Ender 3, my point is it just keeps getting better. And I'm hoping Ender 3 does the same thing. I mean, this went from a cheap Ender 3 clone with, you know, cutting corners, single bearings, and crappy cable to a better cable, the dual bearings, and in general, more features than Ender 3 has. And then they took it further and made the electronics better. So this is kind of like an Ender 3 Pro, you know, with better electronics. They've got the flat rail like the Ender 3 Pro, so the bed's more stable. I love this, you know, build material, but it's pushing the envelope. It's making the sub $200 printer market even better. So I'm hoping this pushes Creality Ender 3 to maybe start releasing Ender 3 with the silent board installed, with a metal extruder, and maybe some Capricorn tubing. So I love the direction, and the fact that they're pushing this, it's fantastic. So if you're looking for a second printer and, you know, you got about $200 budget, I think this is a good option. Especially if you want to, you know, try some different firmware with the 256K memory, you can add a lot more features like, say, Linear Advance, which would be tougher to do on an Ender 3 with the limited memory. Or maybe as new features come out in Marlin, you'll be able to do it here, which you probably won't be able to do on the limited memory of an Ender 3. So I still love the Ender 3, but this is definitely a good competitor. And if you're looking for something easier to assemble, this is it, because this whole upper portion comes fully assembled. It's basically four bolts to mount this to the base, mount the LCD, mount the spool holder, connect the wires, and you're running. So it's even easier to install or assemble for, say, a kid or a family just getting started with 3D printing. So I like this. I still am a fan of Ender 3, but I like where this is going. I like that we're pushing the envelope and making the sub $200 printer market even better. I'll put links to all these in the description below if you want to buy one. It really does help the channel. But make sure you know what you're buying, because I found GearBest, which I got this one from, has it with this metal front when you say A10. Also, Banggood had the same thing. But on Amazon, some of them were selling this one as A10. I haven't seen this one on Amazon yet. And if you go to the Geeetech website, they have both of them, 209 and 179. So that way you know exactly what you're getting. So just double check before you purchase. I'll put the links to the A10 for all of them, but just double check what you're getting.